Speaking of beyond project strategic risk, the fourth speaker is Eddie Loh. He is the director with the risk consulting services practice of Deloitte. He has more than 20 years of working experience in software solution, business performance improvement, and supply chain management, serving mainly FMCG and general manufacturing industries. His key area of active expertise includes IT strategy, operational risk management, and project management on behalf of his clients. With this experience, he has been able to successfully assist clients in improving their operational processes, selections of solutions, and project managing their implementation of commercial software solutions. With this, I want to lend your hand to give a round of applause to our next speaker, Eddie Loh, on Beyond Project Strategic Risk. Beyond Project Strategic Risk.
Good afternoon. I know I'm between you all and lunch. I have not had my lunch yet, and I haven't had my breakfast yet, so I'm pretty low on sugar now. So that's why my voice is a little bit more Lady Gaga-like now. Right? This particular topic is a little bit more dry compared to the Gen X and the Ys and the Zs and so on. But I like to refer to Lily's speech just now, with her permission, about things that is actually around us every day. It's about risk. Lily spoke about during the Gen X. I'm an X-Man, by the way. And my kids are Zach, is that right? Right, from the 1990s upwards until today. During my time, or even all my colleagues' brothers' time, we have absolutely zero risk. We do anything we want. I just asked my kids last night over dinner, have you climbed trees before? There was a blank look, right? And they came back as well. I think they're a little bit more better than some of their classmates in the universities. They came back pretty frustrated about, number one, the knowledge of history. So it's not about risk, it's about understanding risk by looking at past. He came back one day and told me, my friends do not know who Elvis Presley is. That's not so good, right? So, risk is everywhere. We have zero risk. When we fall down during when we play football, we fall down, we have scratches and bleeding from our knees and even our elbows. We go back home, we get beaten by our parents. Because the question is, why do you fall down? I mean, I'm playing football. And I'm playing rugby, I represent rugby for my school. Definitely this could be blood, otherwise you're not a man, right? So, we get beaten up. Today, parents are a lot more risk conscious. You do not allow even your kids to even learn how to ride a bicycle. Come on. Right? Or even go in the drain and look for fishes. Are there still fishes or guppies in drains nowadays? I'm not sure about that. Right? Okay. Now, strategic risk is nothing new in this world, all right? It's just a term that's been coined by consulting organizations like us, right? It's about understanding risk from the board upwards. But however, when it comes to risk, it's about moving forward. It's about organizations planning for their business strategies and business innovation for the next 3 years, 5 years, and at the same time, taking a look at the back of the shoulder and find what are the potential risks that may occur, right, if they were to execute their business plan. Pretty straightforward. So these are some of the comments from some of the bankers as well as someone from Cisco Corporation. It's about when we develop a strategy, right, if I were to take it a bit lower, when you develop a plan, we think about the risks associated with it, but also business risks, they are minimized by following that particular strategy. So, if the board of directors think about risk, right, make it flow downwards to all their staff and create what we call a risk culture.